Why are there 83 commits in my merge request? I only pushed 5 commits to my feature branch. That's weird. Why do I keep getting merge conflicts in this file, even though I've fixed it multiple times in previous updates from the developer branch? If these questions sound familiar, you are not alone. Many developers have been in this frustrating situation. I've experienced it myself countless times. And today, I'm here to unravel these mysteries and clear up some common misconceptions about Git that can make things seem confusing or unexpected. My journey with Git began over a decade ago, although I can't pinpoint the exact year. It's been at least since 2012. Before that, I navigated through other version control systems like CVS, or Concurrent Version System, SVN, and Mercurial. While each had its quirks, Git became my favorite, despite the initial struggle with merge conflicts. Over time, I became adept at managing feature branches and switching between them, keeping them up to date with develop, cherry-picking commits when needed, and resolving merge conflicts. However, things took a turn when I joined a team that adopted squash commits for our merge requests. This approach streamlined our commit history, which I appreciated. But sometimes I found myself stuck at explaining to reviewers why do I have over 30 or even over 80 commits in my merge request when I'm sure I only pushed 6 commits to my feature branch. To get to the bottom of this, we first need to understand the differences between Git merge, Git rebase, and Git squash commits. So let's dive in and demystify these Git commands and see how to avoid unexpected results. Mastering Git, the dark side of squash commits. Your guide to staying sane when adopting the squash commit strategy. Git merge. It combines changes from one branch into another. This creates a new merge commit if there are new commits in both branches. Commit history. Git merge retains the history of both branches, resulting in a nonlinear history. Usage in teams. It's commonly used when integrating changes from a shared branch like develop into a feature branch. This maintains the commit history for traceability. Conflicts. Merge conflicts occur if the same parts of the same files are changed in both branches. They need to be resolved before completing the merge. Git rebase. It moves or rebases commits from one branch to another. This rewrites the commit history to make it appear as if the work was done on top of the new base branch. Commit history. Git rebase creates a linear history, making it easier to follow. Usage in teams. It's often used to keep a feature branch up to date with the latest changes from develop before merging. This can minimize merge conflicts and make the commit history easier to read. Conflicts. Rebase conflicts need to be resolved for each commit being rebased. This can be more tedious, but results in cleaner history. Git squash commits. It combines multiple commits into a single commit. This is often done during a merge request to simplify the commit history. Git squash commits reduces clutter in the history by consolidating many small commits into one. This simplifies commit history, but it leads to losing granular commit history. Usage in teams. It helps keep the main branch's history clean and focused, showing only meaningful consolidated changes. Conflicts. Squashing itself doesn't cause conflicts, but resolving conflicts before squashing is necessary. Why do you see tons of commits in your merge request? Now that we set the stage, let's tackle the first question about the unexpected commits count. To illustrate this, let's walk through a scenario. Initial setup, create feature and sub-feature branches. You create a feature branch from develop called feature branch 1. You create a sub-feature branch from feature branch 1 called feature branch 101 and work on it, updating sub-feature branch. You update feature branch 101 by merging develop into it locally before pushing it to the remote repository. This incorporates all new commits from develop into feature branch 101. These commits are added to develop by other developers after you created feature branch 1 from it. If you check the history of feature branch 101, you will see all the commits from develop. Updating feature branch. You create a merge request with the option squash commit to update feature branch 1 by merging develop into it. Squashing results in feature branch 1 having a single new commit, but the detailed commit history from develop is lost in feature branch 1. All the new commits which were added to develop by other developers after you created feature branch 1 from it and their individual commit IDs won't appear in the history of feature branch 1. Merging sub-feature branch into feature branch. You create a merge request to merge feature branch 101 into feature branch 1 and choose squash commit. Observations. When you view the devs view of the final merge request, you notice a lot of commits. Why? These aren't just the commits from the sub-feature work in feature branch 101. These are the individual commits from develop that feature branch 101 received from merging develop into it. And there you have it. This is why there are a ton of commits in the merge request. If the feature branch 1, was kept up to date with develop by merging it without the squash commit option, you can end up seeing only the commits related to the work in feature branch 101 when creating the merge request from the sub-feature branch into the feature branch 1. Why do you keep having merge conflicts in files that you fixed previously? Feeling like you are stuck in a loop, fixing the same merge conflicts over and over, is frustrating. So let's unravel why those pesky merge conflicts keep reappearing. We need first to repeat the previous scenario, but with additional steps. Initial setup. Create feature and sub-feature branches. You create a feature branch from develop, called feature branch 1. You create a sub-feature branch from feature branch 1, called feature branch 101, and work on it. Updating branches and resolving conflicts. As development progresses, you need to synchronize feature branch 101 with the latest changes from develop. You merge develop into feature branch 101 locally and encounter merge conflicts. You resolve these conflicts in your code editor and push the updated branch to the remote repository. Next, you update feature branch 1 by merging develop into it. You do it through a merge request and choose the option squash commits, resulting in a single commit added to the history of feature branch 1. Then you merge feature branch 101 into feature branch 1 using another merge request, again opting to squash commits, repeating the process. The cycle continues. You create another sub-feature branch from feature branch 1 called feature branch 102 and start working on it. When it's time to update feature branch 102 with the latest changes from develop, you merge develop into feature branch 102 on your local machine. To your frustration, you face the same merge conflicts you dealt with before, and you have to manually resolve them again in your code editor. Why does this happen? Explanation. Here is the scope. Branch-specific resolutions. When you resolved conflicts in your feature branch 101, those resolutions are specific to that branch. They don't automatically carry over to other branches. Squash commits and lost history. When you squash merge feature branch 1, the detailed commit history from develop isn't retained. The squash commit only records the final state after the merge, not the individual commits and their conflict resolutions. A new sub-feature branch issues. When you create a new sub-feature branch, feature branch 102 from feature branch 1, and merge develop, Git doesn't recognize the previous conflict resolutions. Those resolutions were part of a history that got squashed, lost. Because of this, Git treats this situation as it's encountering these conflicts for the first time. It doesn't see the past resolutions and requires you to manually resolve the conflicts again. This can be frustrating, but understanding this behavior helps manage and anticipate these recurring conflicts more effectively. To sum it up, navigating Git's complexities can be challenging, but with the right insights, you can become a master and tackle tricky Git situations with confidence. Understanding the nuances of Git merge, rebase, and squash commits unlocks the door to smoother workflows and transforms frustrating merge requests and conflicts into manageable tasks. So keep your branches updated without losing crucial commit history. And remember how conflict resolutions are specific to each branch. This way you can avoid those unexpected 83 commit merge requests and recurrent merge conflicts. Keep pushing forward and happy coding. That's it for today. If you liked the video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. And see you next time.